I definitely discriminate against men that paint their nails and wear dresses. I don't really care how you feel about that. You can wear your dress and you can paint your nails, but I'd prefer you keeping 100 feet away from a playground and all of the feet away from my children and me. If I see you, I'm going to cross the street if I'm with my kids. Oh, Candace, it's not accepting. We need to be more accepting of the people, the men who like to wear panties. I'm good. You can be more accepting of it. You run that risk when you see a guy who looks like a freak and you're with your children and say, to be accepting, I'm going to put my kids next to him. And it's a survival mechanism, right? We want to survive. And so when we get that feeling, my mother used to refer to it as the heebie-jeebies. When someone just gives you the heebie-jeebies, even if you can't quite put your finger on why, I think you need to lean into that. And I actually think that society would be safer if we discriminated more. What's happening now is insanity because they're telling us to accept everything. To say, oh, it's just so, oh, it's fine. He just has a fetish. He likes to wear panties.
Oh, the heebie-jeebies. Yeah, I knew I felt something weird when her face got up on the screen. Yes, it's that feeling. No, she's terrible. Look, she is lashing out at people that she apparently on a visceral level fears and despises and can't understand it. Now, she's not the sort of person that would actually like look into herself, do a little bit of self-analysis and figure out why she feels this aversion to people who paint their nails. Why that for some reason is a thing. I bet her nails are painted in that video. Why it's totally normal, totally acceptable for her. But if a man were to do that, then he's probably gonna murder her kids. That makes no sense. There's no evidence to support that. She feels it anyway and is not the sort of person able to do the sort of critical analysis of herself that she would be able to look past that. And that somehow is our problem, I guess. You can call other people a freak, Candace Owens, but let's be clear about who the freak is. It's the person who loses their mind if they see someone with painted nails. I would say that's a little bit freakier. And you apparently, as she says, propagandizing to her kids to try to get them to feel those same sorts of heebie-jeebies. The joke is gonna be on her because younger generations are already far more accepting of a wide range of different groups that have been demonized throughout American history. And that's now. Her kids are probably young. God only knows by the time they get to college age what they're gonna think about their mom's politics. But I'll leave that for her to discover going forward. River, what do you think?
I mean, I just, what a heartbreaking display of violent thoughts, you know, like she just, I mean, I hope the money's good, you know,
I think it is.
Yeah, it's good. It's probably good. But you know, money isn't everything. And I just, you know, it's just really sad to me, how hard people are going because people are literally getting killed because of this stuff. I mean, this kind of messaging, this kind of propaganda, this sort of fascism is why Club Q happened. And we lost so many people there, so many beloved and cared for people there. And I will just say, like, she is talking about trans women and calling them men, which is disgusting and inaccurate. And also, I just want to say, you know, armed Proud Boys are showing up at drag queen story hours, which are sometimes trans women and sometimes not. But I just want to point out that those people, those drag queens, are taking time out of their lives to read to children. And I don't see any of these people doing that. I don't see the Proud Boys doing that. Cause that, if you actually had a problem with it and you think it's wrong, the answer to it would be to go do it, not to show up with AR-15s and grenades and all that. They are literally marking people for violence. And that's all that this is. And I'm not being hyperbolic. It's happening, we're watching it happen. But I, John, I appreciate your point though, that generations the acceptance is not even an action for them, it's already there. And so this is why these people are screaming and clawing and clutching and showing up with guns because they know that they've already lost this fight. And so they're trying to start it again. But we live in a different society now and they refuse to allow that to happen. And it's very scary. It's not over, you know? So yeah, those are my thoughts on Candace Owens.
Meanwhile, really fast, the effect of this sort of discrimination that she wants to see more of, by the way, oh, and just a brief little note, she butters her bread now by advocating for more discrimination. Back before she was a Trump fan, she actually started an anti-bullying website because she said she had been bullied for her race in college, which I don't doubt she was. Now, see, being compassionate and anti-bullying was how she thought she'd make money then. Now, advocating for more active bullying and harassment is how she makes her money. She inside of her skin is an empty void of madness and hatred and fear. That's all she is. She has no values, and is just having a completely negative impact on people's lives, advocating for more discrimination. Here's an example of that sort of discrimination. 49-year-old Ashlan Williams confronted a 36-year-old transgender woman and a friend in front of an apartment building in Manhattan. Williams told the pair to quiet down because people were trying to sleep. He allegedly misgendered the victim and called her an anti-LGBTQ plus slur. He then stabbed her twice in the face with a sharp object, causing lacerations above her right eye. He then pulled out a gun and fired at the victim three times, thankfully missing, before fleeing on a moped. Is now being charged with assault in the second degree as a hate crime, attempted assault in the first degree as a hate crime, criminal possession of a weapon in the second degree, and menacing in the second degree as a hate crime. But we need more of it. We need more violence and hatred and fear and harassment and threats. That's what we need more of. Imagine having a platform the size of a Candace Owens and using it for that. By the way, isn't it weird that she has seemingly fully gotten out with any blame for her involvement with Kanye West? Remember, she was the one that like kicked this off with the like White Lives Matter t-shirt, and then he spun out of control with all the anti-Semitism, and she seems totally clear of all that, even though she's like friends with him.